Good morning, this is Dr. Ghiassi from Ortega Dental Care. And we have another completed orthodontic case. This is for a teenager. And let's go ahead and review that together. Okay, so upper and lower jaw, excessive crowding there. Even though the middle of the upper and lower jaw are pretty lined up, but we have a retained baby tooth, a primary canine tooth, an eye tooth, which never fell off, and an adult canine just never came out. And when upper or lower jaw are very narrow, we have impacted adult teeth, but that don't have a chance to fully erupt. And later on, this becomes a surgical case, and you actually have to go in and open up the gum there, open up the bone, put braces on that, start bringing it out. And that's why early orthodontic treatments are really beneficial to prevent surgical type treatments. We did treat this case non-surgical regarding the extraction, but she did have to have a surgery to open up the gum to get that lower canine tooth slowly erupted. But there was no other teeth that were extracted for her case. So let's look at the upper jaw. Definitely can see a very narrow upper jaw, and the canine tooth has very little space for it to erupt. And definitely lower jaw is the main issue. That this is a baby tooth that never erupted and never exfoliated. And the adult canine tooth was fully impacted. Let's look at this as well. Very, very crowded upper jaw and lower jaw there. Okay, let's go ahead and review the x-ray. On this x-ray, we can definitely see the impacted lower canine. If you see the lower impacted canine, how she start causing damage to the anterior to teeth. These are lower front teeth. You can actually see the roots are going sideways and it's getting damaged. So this canine tooth is trying to push out and it just can't. So start dissolving the roots of the adult teeth, and that is not good. And we'd like to catch these at early ages. Same thing with the upper jaw. The upper canine tooth is kind of stuck. It just can't come out without help, and it will cause damage to the roots of the adjacent teeth there. So it's very, very important to start these cases at early age. And let's go through the final results. Beautiful results. Upper and lower midline line up beautifully. Upper jaw is wide enough. The canine that was stuck inside, we brought it down with braces. Same thing, this canine tooth that was impacted into the lower part of the mandible was brought back and up. Of course, we are suggesting some tissue grafting, gum grafting in this area to make it more aesthetic, make it look like this other side as well. But the positioning of the upper and lower jaw is ideal. Let's look at the upper photos. Everything is lined up beautifully, nice and wide arch, gorgeous. Same thing with the lower jaw, beautiful, nice and wide there, and everything's lined up, non-surgical, I mean non-extraction. This was a surgical case, but it was a non-extraction. We didn't pull out any teeth there to widen the upper and lower jaw there. You can definitely see very, very good bite on both sides. And but yeah, we always suggest early treatment, so just to prevent impacted canines or impacted bicuspids from damaging other teeth there. Okay, have a wonderful day.